Good day and welcome to Mission Control Houston, where the team of flight controllers is watching over the systems aboard the International Space Station as it continues to circle the globe at 17,500 miles an hour. On board the space station, Expedition 34, commanded by NASA astronaut Kevin Ford, along with his two Russian cosmonaut colleagues, Oleg Novitsky and Evgeny Tarelkin, are continuing their work today. Kevin Ford is working on a number of different activities on this very busy day. He's unpacking medical kit supplies that were delivered on the most recent Progress 49 spacecraft. He's also going to be getting into some work cleaning out the crew quarters that will be used by Chris Hadfield once he's arrived. That's a several-hour activity to make sure that everything is spick and span. The team on the ground and on orbit likes to try and clean those out when they are vacant and make them all spick and span and ready for the newly arriving crew members. Novitsky did some updates on the software of the Russian computers and also worked on the Kolob-Crispell experiment, which is studying the dynamics of solids that are dispersed in liquids using a magnetic field. Evgeny Tarelkin is checking the windows in the Russian segment to make sure they're all in good shape and that they'll be able to be used for monitoring of the arrival of the next spacecraft to the space station, which is the Soyuz that's going to be launching the next crew. Coming up on Wednesday. That Soyuz spacecraft was rolled out to the launch pad today. It's going to be delivering NASA astronaut Tom Marshburn and Canadian astronaut Chris Hadfield, who later will become the first Canadian commander of the International Space Station, and Russian cosmonaut Roman Romanenko, who will be the commander of the Soyuz spacecraft TMA-07M itself. It is a particularly frosty day out in Kazakhstan today for the rollout. It is setting records that were set in 1950, or updating records set in 1950, with some areas of Kazakhstan going down as far as minus 43 degrees Fahrenheit. The temperature at the launch pad in Baikonur Cosmodrome was minus 25 Fahrenheit today. Very dangerous temperatures for the teams preparing the spacecraft, but they are managing to complete their work as planned. Just to run down on the plan, the spacecraft is scheduled to launch at 6:12 a.m. Central Time. Here we see some video that was downlinked earlier of the preparations. This is the escape rocket system for the Soyuz spacecraft. And then on Friday, December the 21st, the trio is going to be docking their Soyuz to the space station's Rosviet module, which is on the Russian segment, about 8:12 a.m. Central Time. Wednesday's launch coverage begins at 5 a.m. Central Time, with launch again scheduled for 6:12 a.m., and then we'll have a post-launch video file at 9 a.m. Central. On Friday, we'll be getting ready for the docking coverage, which begins at 7:30 a.m. Central, and then docking again is planned at 8:12 a.m., and the hatch opening coverage begins at 10:15 a.m., followed by hatch opening and welcome ceremonies at 10:45 a.m., and then our post-docking video file at 1 p.m. The International Space Station Mission Management Team met today to go over all of the plans and preparations for launch and docking and gave a unanimous go for the rendezvous and docking of the Soyuz with the International Space Station to round out to a crew of six. Right now, the International Space Station is orbiting high above China on a southeasterly course. All systems are working well, and the crew is busily continuing its tasks.